Hi, I'm Paulshinn. Today I'm putting a brand new wiring harness in a 1931 Ford Model A, and I'm going to show you how. Hello friends, welcome back to the Boomer Box, and for this edition of Operation Hooptie, which, after pulling all the old wiring out of this car in the last episode and deeming it 97.3% Hooptie free, I don't know if we can call Athena a Hooptie anymore or not. I don't know, maybe this is just Operation Model A getting it back on the road or something. So anyway, in this video I'm going to be putting in the wiring finally, as you've been waiting for a really long time, and in doing so I'm also, as I told you before, converting this back from 12 volts back to 6 volt positive ground, just like it left the factory. And that means I'm going to be putting the 6 volt halogen headlights in, fixing the lights inside the car, changing out the cowl lights, etc., etc. This car is also getting turn signals with its new wiring harness, so that's what the cowl lights are going to be doing facing forward. And in the rears I'm going to be using the teacup tail lights, and so that's kind of the way it should look, right? Anyway, let's get started on this. Number one, when you're putting in wiring in a Model A, it's so much easier to do it just laying on the garage floor. And I know everybody who has a lift, especially when you first get your lift, you want to use your lift for absolutely everything. It's like, I mean, I actually kind of even thought about serving Thanksgiving dinner on the lift by just putting it up this high and then putting paper on it. But you know, you do that when you buy a lift. You just want to use it for everything. This is not one of those times. This is one of those times where it's a lot easier doing the job just laying here on the concrete floor. Now, my concrete floor happens to be covered with epoxy, makes it really easy to slide around if you're wearing a cotton t-shirt. That's the best way to do this. Putting it on the lift actually makes it harder to do this, and you'll see why in a few minutes. But let's get started and let's start putting some wiring under this car. Lay this out here on the floor next to the car, the way everything's gonna kinda go. And I'll use the wiring for the, here's the horn and headlights. So let's get this out of the way. Get this ready, stretch this all out. The difference is, if you're doing a wiring harness that has turn signals, is this right here. This part is what's going to connect to the turn signal controller. So we're going to keep that right about where it's going to go. The light switch is right about there. Stretch this out. I'll start getting these pieces kind of put back together. We'll move it under the car, and then we'll start attaching it to the chassis. Here's the wiring schematic for this harness. Just pause the video here and print it out if you need it. Now with your wiring harness all laid out, make sure there's no tangles in it, no twists. It's time to go ahead and start fishing it through the light switch cover. Don't forget to do this. If you put the whole wiring harness in the car and then realize you forgot to put this on, you will cuss. Well, good morning. It has been many, 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 many days since you last saw me. And this morning I spent some time getting this car off the lift. This is the Honda that I saved from the crusher, and I'm almost done with it. Luckily that car drives, so that was easy. But this car is currently not driving because we don't have wiring in it yet. So I pushed this car around, pushed it onto the lift, and now I'm going to show you how to install the wiring harness. Again, this is much easier to do laying on the garage floor flat. It just is impossible to film it that way, so I can show you what I'm doing. So I'm going to do it on the lift, which is the hard way. I do everything the hard way. Okay, I know you guys can see this now. There's the end of the steering column, and this is where the light switch mounts. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stretch this wiring harness back out and kind of lay it on the lift here. Get this wafer ready to go in here. I'm gonna start attaching the wiring where it needs to go on the frame using these little clips. There's short ones and long ones. This is a short one. This clip is how we attach this. It goes like this over the top of the wire like that. And then the bottom of the C rail of the frame, it just clips right on and holds the wire right on top of the bottom of the C rail right here. So I'm gonna get started on that now, and you get to watch that kind of in fast motion so I don't waste your time. wires in the middle of the harness go to the brake light switch, which is right here, middle of the car. And for those of you wondering why I'm perspiring like a prostitute in church, it has now reached over 100 degrees Fahrenheit out here. Not pleasant. If I were to turn my head so that I could see what I was doing, I'd be in front of the camera. There we go, brake light switch attached. They're not touching anything. That should do it. Right, now we get to test fit the light switch together. I got the brand new light switch assembly here. It goes in like that. So we can get all this to fit together, hopefully. These new light switches are kind of tight. All right, I'll put the bail on it. There we go. All right, that's all together now. Now I can start attaching my wiring to the frame and all that in the correct position, and then routing the wires up to the headlight buckets, to the horn. Then I got to connect the turn signal assembly here, run the wires under the floor, and then connect the cowl lights for the turn signals, put the tail lights together. There's lots to do. Well, with my work schedule and the heat of the day that we've been having, I don't get a lot of time to work on this car, but it has been a couple days, time to get back to work on Athena. So as you saw, I left the pigtails from the 12 volt halogens in the headlight buckets running in behind the radiator. I left those for a reason. I'm gonna reuse these. The 6 volt halogens use the exact same plug. So I'm not gonna reinvent the wheel because mainly I didn't have any more of these. These are the only ones I have. So the halogen headlights work really well. Now, the trick is to know what wire goes where on this when you're gonna wire this up. So if you're holding this against you like this, you'll see this pin here, if you have it in the shape of a U, this pin is the common, or what we're going to call ground for our purposes. The pin over here on this side, your right, not on video, but this is the low beam, and then the one that points down towards your feet, this is the high beam. That's important to know when we wire this up. And these particular jumpers here, that means black is going to be the common, and it looks like red is going to be low beam, and green is going to be high beam. So I'm going to get ready to put these in so then I can start the wiring into the headlights. But first, I have to put new cork gasket around these, and I have a really easy way of doing it I'm going to share with you right now. This mini fridge has become another very useful work surface. It also makes a good place to keep your super glue, because if the super glue is kept in the fridge, it lasts a lot longer. So putting the cork around these, the trick is always keeping these steady. So I use one of my wife's bowls. An empty 1 gallon paint can also works well. So start with the top, and I labeled this somewhere. There it is, top. So start with the top. So this is the top pin. And what I'll do is I'll start away from me. So if there's any gap in the cork, I want it to be on the bottom. So theoretically it would drain that way. So the trick to getting these to stay is to use super glue. I know that's cheating, but I just put a little dab of super glue around the rim every once in a while. Just a little dot. That's all it takes. Little dot. Nothing fancy. That's it. Let's get a little better one here on the end. There we go. All right. Now, I'll start by putting this here. You got to make sure that it fits square into the little recess here. Not at a weird angle, because then it won't seal properly. All the way around, make sure it fits. If there's a spot where it feels like it's not fitting correctly or whatever, just put a drop of super glue in there and then go back and fit it. Okay, now these are always too long, which is good. Just give it a little snip and then boom, done. All right, time to put the headlight assembly together. Thankfully, one of the previous owners glued in a screw from the back, so it looks like the regular stock headlights with the focusing screw. The screw's just glued in, though, so that was kind of cool. Saved me the trouble. So I hook these up. Should they fit nice? Sure, I've got top on the top. Yes, I do. There we go. Hold that in like so. Now, people always tell you, don't ever touch halogen bulbs. But, yeah, it happens. So if that does happen, just get you some isopropyl alcohol, put a little bit of it on a terry cloth rag, and then you can wipe. I know, don't do this at home, kids. You can wipe the bulb to get your fingerprints off, dry it, and now you don't have to worry about the bulb blowing up prematurely because you left some finger oils on it. There we go. Now the next one. Now with all that out of the way, now we can get back to wiring up a Model A. So here is the other end of that wiring harness. So here's the wires that go to the horn. This right here is the wire that goes to the generator cutout, or in our case, the alternator. This is going to the driver's side headlamp, and this is going to go to the passenger's side headlamp. So let's start by figuring out where these are going to route. Now this stuff here that goes on this side is going to go up underneath the radiator mount here. So I'll take this aside because that's going to go to the generator, or in this case, the alternator. And I'll fish these past this radiator mount here. Sorry if my big hands get in the way. Okay, that's going to go to the headlight. These are going to go to the horn. Fish these under. There we go. Okay, that all goes there. This is going to loop back around and go there, so I'm going to leave that right there. And then this is going to end up going underneath. Now it's got to go under that too. Underneath the radiator outlet here. And it's going to go across. There's little tabs on the bottom of a Model A radiator that are designed to hold this wire here. This radiator has some makeshift wire instead, so I can't exactly show you how those work, but in this case, that's all right, because all it has to do is just keep this wire from getting tangled up in the pulley or the belt or any of that kind of stuff. So temporarily, I'm just going to leave that laying right there, and I'm going to concentrate on these. First thing I'm going to do is fish the horn wires through the conduit here. Get ready to wire the horn. Now with the headlight wires routed, we're ready to hook up headlights. Of course, I'm using halogens, which means I'm going to be hooking up to these pigtails here. Now, those of you who have ever cussed at, or correction, installed the stock Model A headlight sockets knows these connectors very well, and knows that they have a tendency to short if not put exactly bright inside. So what I do is I use my Dremel tool sometimes, and I cut these down so that they're not so big around when I'm putting the stock sockets in. But in this particular case, since I'm wiring to pigtails anyway, I'm not going to use any of that. I'm going to use these, which is the male-female end of these butt splices that can come apart. So if I ever have to take the headlights off, like if I'm going to replace the radiator or something or pull the motor, I can just unplug and then fish them back through. So that's the plan here, is I'm just going to go ahead and wire these up this way, and they'll be inside here. I'll do it kind of nice so they don't get tangled in anything, and then it'll be easy to just disconnect right here if you got to pull the radiator or something. So make that easy. Now for the ground connection, I'm just going to use these because one of the previous owners was kind enough to put a nice little screw right here with a nut on it. So I'll just make my ground right here to that, and that'll be that. Now, if for some reason I ever want to go back to the stock Model A sockets, no big deal. These connectors are easily available from all the Model A part suppliers, so you can always just put some of these connectors right back on these wires, fish them through, and you can go back to stock headlamps anytime you want. We're going to do the same thing on this side we did on that side. As far as routing the wire goes, this is the wire for the passenger side headlight. And you can see some of the funky wire that's been used keep this out of the way here. So there's this nice little thing that a previous owner left here for this wire to roll through, which is kind of nice and a convenient place to connect our ground wire. So I'm going to go ahead and take this apart. I'll run wire through there and use it. Why not? I mean, it's there. What the heck? I'll do the same thing. I'm going to cut these ends off as much as it hurts. I know, but it's all for a good cause. Also, by not using the stock headlight sockets, tends to make the halogens that draw more current a little more reliable, I guess, using these type of connectors. The stock sockets for headlights aren't really designed to take the kind of current that these halogens draw. And in case you're wondering why I'm putting the male ends on the car wiring, that's for testing. It just makes it easier to troubleshoot when you're trying to figure out what's going on, having these ends on this side here. If you're using your ohm voltmeter to do your troubleshooting, just makes it easier. And the reason why it's kind of a bad idea to solder connections on a car like this, if you solder these, which I've seen a lot of people do, the solder tends to wick backwards into the wire and it makes it kind of brittle. So if you bend it back and forth, it just breaks right off, versus if it's not soldered and it bends back and forth like this, it just rolls with it, doesn't break. There we go. Now I'll connect the lug on this one. We'll connect these and be good to go. These somewhere nice and out of the way here. Make sure they don't get eaten up by the fan or visible from the front of the car. All right, now I got to do is get some more wire or zip ties or something, and I'll attach this to the radiator down here. Normally there would be the little metal clips I was telling you about you'd bend around, but yeah, well, this is still kind of a hooptie. Can't lose all the hooptiness in one day, I guess, so we'll just kind of re-hooptie it. All right, it'll retain a small amount of hooptiness. It's time now for that magic moment you've all been waiting for. Gonna put the alternator in. And I know I told you I was gonna show you how to convert the alternator to 6-volt positive ground. I still will do that, but this video is already running way long as it is. So I'll do that next time. We'll do that for sure. Maybe just make a club seminar out of it for sure, because it's actually pretty easy and I want to show you how. All right, done. Now the electrical connection, which is right here. Even before I wire the taillights in, I want to get the rest of the car wired at least enough to where we can get it to run again. So I've got a brand new generator wiring harness here. So this is the wire that goes from the generator, in our case the alternator, and the starter switch up to the terminal box. So there's two colors of wire in here. There's the yellow and then there's the yellow and black. The yellow and black goes on the driver's side of the terminal box. The plain yellow is the one that comes from the starter switch, only we're going to be installing a inline fuse on the starter. You can get these at all the Model A part suppliers. This is an old one I just had around. So I'm going to put this on the starter and then I'm going to wire this in, install this, wire it into the terminal box, and then we're going to take it from there. Next is the instrument panel harness, and again, this car is getting a brand new assembly here. So this has three wires in it. The yellow with black tracer goes from the driver's side of the terminal box up to the charge post on the ammeter. The yellow wire goes to the passenger side of the terminal box here. The other end goes to the discharge post on the ammeter. The red wire is going to go up to the ignition switch, and on this end the red wire is going to come out of the terminal box and up to the positive post on the coil. I haven't put the coil in yet because I wanted to be able to show you this more clearly. So that's the end that goes up in the car. Let's fish this through. And we're gonna have to go inside the car and fish this through the channel on the bottom of the fuel tank inside the car now so that we can route it to the instrument panel. Okay, now all we have to do is attach these wires to our amp meter. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put the battery in and power up the system before we screw the dash panel back onto the fuel tank here. We're just going to do a test. We're going to turn on the headlights and make sure that the amp meter says discharge. If for some reason the amp meter reads charge when you turn on the headlights during that test, then all we have to do is swap these two wires around right here and then it'll read properly. Sorry, my big fat hands are in the way again. Okay, those are on. This is the light for the dash here that's going to route it through there. The red wire here, this goes to the ignition switch. Connect that. Get the washer too. Unfortunately, there's no good way to record this without my big fat hands in the way, so again, sorry about that. I'll stay out of the way as best I can. All right, there. And they're tight for now. Again, we're not going to mount the dash until we do that test to make sure that the amp meter is reading properly. Now we're going to go hook up the other side. Okay, so yellow with black stripe goes on the driver's side. Solid yellow goes on the passenger side. And again, the red wire is going to go directly to the positive terminal on the coil, which is going to be the passenger side terminal on the coil. So I'm just going to move that over here and keep that out of the way. So when it comes out of the terminal box, the cutout for this wire and the black wire, which is going to be on this side to the negative terminal, those cutouts are in the lid that goes over the top of this. So I'll just put these here temporarily because we got a couple more things to hook up. All right, time to get a battery in this thing. I love these Optima 6-volt batteries. These things are fantastic. People that have switched to 12 volts, I ask them why sometimes. It's because, oh, because it cranks so much better on 12 volts. But actually, if you try one of these Optima 6-volt batteries, you'd be surprised how well those will turn over a 6-volt Model A. So I made the call to Burt's Model A Center and bought one of these handy-dandy Optima battery hold-down brackets. And this car, at some point, one of the previous owners installed a battery cutoff switch here, and which is why I'm kind of wiring this kind of goofy way that's sitting here. So rather than reinvent the wheel right now at this point, I might change it later, but for right now, I'm just going to go ahead and use the wiring that the previous owner put in using the battery cutoff switch and then this ground wire that goes to the clamshell here on the engine instead of to the frame. So that's why this looks goofy. I might change this later, but then again, I don't know, maybe not. I mean, I gotta leave some hooptiness in here, but at least it'll have a good battery. Time to put my super superior soldering skills to work. I'm gonna make that short black wire that runs from the driver's side of the terminal box to the negative terminal on the coil. And yeah, I'm soldering it because I don't like these things to fail. There we go. Perfect. Now's a good time to go ahead and mount the coil in the car. If you look at your coil really closely, you'll notice there's a positive and a negative terminal. See that? The negative terminal, this one right here, that needs to go towards the driver's side of the car. The positive terminal needs to go towards the passenger side. The reason is this red wire, the one that goes up to the ignition switch, needs to go to the positive. This black wire that goes here on the terminal box needs to go to the negative. Now you'll notice those are not the right nuts. These are not what's supposed to be on a coil, but these are what were on this coil. It works, and I don't have the right nuts, so at least for right now, that's the way it's going to be. So, negative side towards the driver's side. Let's mount this somewhere convenient here. like so. I'll go ahead and loosen this just a little. Tighten this first, and then when I tighten the two slot head screws, then they'll have the right tension and stuff on them. Okay, now position this kind of in the middle. Does that look about centered to you? Just kind of wrapping this kind of like that, sort of. Now the black one, take this around here. It's going to end up coming out of the terminal box about right there. And it'll just kind of loop around and I'll put it on right there like that. I can adjust this later and make it look pretty however I want. It's a new morning, back to work on the car. So I've got everything pretty well wired up to the junction box here. I've got the coil wired in. I've got the stuff going to the dash panel. All that stuff's in. There still needs to be a wire up to the electric windshield wiper and something for the dome light inside the car. I'm not going to worry about that yet. Main thing I need to worry about right now is, does the amp meter work the correct direction? Do I need to switch those? Because I need to find that out so I can mount the panel back in. I want to make sure the amp meter works the right way. And just for grins, I'm going to see if the thing will run again. So with all these changes to the electrical system, just got to make sure everything's still going to work. So I'll go ahead and just put this on temporarily again. We still got a couple things that need to go in here, but at least for now, I can kind of sort of get it done. At least enough to where we can try out the electrical system we've got so far. I mean, I don't have the turn signal actuator and all that. That's not mounted in the car. It's not even wired yet. But as long as those wires aren't touching anything, we should be safe to hook up battery and make sure we've got at least electricity going to the horn and lights and that kind of stuff. I have to pull that junction box off of there and tighten that properly because it's loose. And if this gets loose and this backs off, guess what it touches? It touches metal, and you don't want that. So I get to take the junction box off now and tighten that. Lovely. Okay, I got these good and tight now, so now they won't back off. But here's a pro tip for you. After you tighten these, you want to make sure that these don't ever back off because these are going to have electrical wires connected to them, electricity on them. If they back out, they will short against the firewall of the car. So what I do is I put a little bit of silicone on the back of this and then let this dry. Then if for some reason these things want to come loose, they're not going to touch the metal of the car. They're not going to short out. They're not going to start a fire. So. All right, time to mount this back. Much better. All right. Now, although I shouldn't, just for safety, I'm going to put the cover back on temporarily here. So I'm still going to be working in here. I still got to connect the wiper and the dome light. But just want to make sure everything's going to look good, fit good. Those little cutouts there, make sure that the wire for the coil and the wire that goes to the ignition switch come out of those just fine. Yeah, put the coil wire. There we go. Now what I got to do is I got to check and make sure that nothing else is going to touch anywhere, make sure everything's clear. So I don't have the taillights connected yet. I don't have the turn signal actuator connected yet. None of that. But I'm just going to make sure none of those wires are touching anything, and I'm going to see if this thing is at least going to run and check that the amp meter is moving the correct direction. All right, I've gone all the way around the car, made sure that everything that isn't hooked up to anything is not touching. So we've got a couple wires hanging here and there, but nothing's touching ground. Should be able to hook up the battery and test at least the headlights and the horn. Ooh, no sparks. That's a good sign. I'm going to check and make sure that the amp meter works the right way, but we have horn. Let's check headlights. Ooh, low beam, high beam, low beam. Yes. And the amp meter does move the correct direction. This is good. All right. Now at least I know that the amp meter is hooked up properly, so I can go ahead and put the dash panel back in now. All right. Time to install the dash panel. Now I'm probably not going to record all this because, to be honest, installing the dash panel, you need like 8 hands to make everything fit. And it usually makes me kind of cuss. And this one was installed with some of the wrong screws, like this sheet metal screw, which tells me that this is probably kind of goofed up anyway. So I'm going to see if I can get a couple screws started, See if I can at least make it work right. Oh, fudge. Oh, pardon my French. Oh, who am I kidding? I don't speak French, but I do kiss that way. All right, get in there. All right, get started. Get started. Oh, nope, that one's stripped. Okay, that's no good. How about this one? I can get this started. Nope, that one's stripped too. Okay, let's get the oversized screws that came in this. Here we go. Ta-da! The trick was to use the mix-match screws that were in it originally, not to use the right screws. And then, good to go. All right, the dash panel's back in. Life is good. Now, let's see if this turkey still runs. That'll be good. That means the coil and all the new stuff I just put in works. You know the difference between me and all the automotive YouTubers out there on YouTube? I don't run my cars with my garage door closed. That's how you know you're a real automotive YouTuber. If you run your cars inside your shop without opening the doors, windows, then you're a real automotive YouTuber. Come on, guys, that's crazy. I'm finally at the stage now where I can put the tail lights back on. I've got the wires for the tail lights just kind of floating down here on each side ready to go, which means I gotta put the brackets back on and all this back together. So the tail lights that were on this originally, when this was 12 volts, somebody had changed and modified the T-cups with some different sockets to accept 12 volt halogen bulbs, which, since I'm converting back to 6 volts, that's no good. But they modified the teacups so they're almost unusable. The back of the teacup's supposed to look like that. And this has some weird socket brazed into it. So these are no good. I can't use these. So I went through the junk at my old man's and got a couple of teacups that I can use. Unfortunately, I do not have the teacup without the glass clear lens on the bottom for the license plate on the driver's side. Normally on the passenger side, you'd buy one of these without that so that you don't, because there's no plate on that side. So what I did was I got another regular stock Model A teacup and took the glass lens out. And then I'm going to modify this with some metal tape. And then this won't have the clear on the bottom. I'll put this on the passenger side. But for the driver's side here, I got to put this together. We've got brand new wiring harnesses for these. Let me pull this out. And then, so here's what the wiring harness looks like. And no, you can't stick it in there without pulling the wire out of the loom first. So you have to first pull this out like that. Black wire is for tail lights, just the regular running lights, if you will. The other wire, green or whatever color this is for the stop and turn signals. So here we go. There we go. They just fit in there just like that. And now they'll accept regular 6-volt bulbs. And now, just put the loom back on here. This is kind of helpful for where the wires feed through the fender and the brace and all that, so you don't rub through the wire and cause a short. All right, so that goes like that. Now I just need to mount this to this bracket here. A couple of screws on there, and we'll be set. Then I can go ahead and reinstall this. Oh, this one actually takes a license plate. Hello! Don't forget the important part. Got to run the wires through here. Oh, that would have been a big snafu, wouldn't it? Okay, there we go. Yeah, California does require license plates on your car, so. And I'm getting around that. Okay, one completed taillight assembly. Make sure I got the rubber on there. I do. This piece that goes on the back side right here. Ta-da! Same deal for the drinker side. Push the wire through there. All are. Dun, 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 dun.
Welcome to the undercar view. So here's the wires coming from the teacup, and here's the wires from the wiring harness. So I'll just use these little couplers here, like so. Black to black, like that. And green to green. There we go. All right, now. Now what I'll do is I'll dress this nice, and I'll get one of those clips, and I'll just kind of attach this real nice and make it look good like that and keep it up out of the way. Okay, back under the car on the drinker side this time. Here's the wire coming from the harness, and this is the wire coming from the teacup. So really simple, just black to black, like so. There we go, and these couplers are available from all the Model A part suppliers. Then the yellow with green stripe to green. That's it, just like that. And then what I'll do is I'll get a clip and I'll dress this up here under the frame real pretty, like that. Keep it out of danger and out of the way. And that'll be done. Then we can move into the middle of the car.
Back in the middle of the car, I have mounted the turn signal switch assembly, which I did not bother filming because it was boring and it took me a lot longer than it should have. So now we're going to connect up this harness that comes from it. And the first thing is this socket here that's going to go to the flasher, which we're going to end up mounting somewhere down here. There's a red wire and a black wire with a black and white striped wire. These are supposed to go to a turn signal alarm, which I am not going to connect because I don't need an alarm going off every time the turn signal is turned on. Black wire with a white stripe, this is going to go to ground, which we're just going to find a ground screw somewhere around here. And then there's all of these wires. These connect to that huge bundle of wires under the car that, if you recall, when we were putting the harness in a little earlier, it's just kind of left dangling down there. This is the part that needs to be fed under the car. So I have removed most of the plate that goes around the steering column, and I'm just going to fish these out through the hole where the steering column goes through the floor. And then on the underside of the car, I'm just going to route it kind of as nice as I can to somewhere kind of convenient, and then I'll start connecting those wires.
Welcome to the undercar cam. So here's the harness I just pulled through from the inside. I'll have to route this so that the clutch pedal doesn't hit it, which won't be that hard to do. Now don't forget, we still have this wire here, which needs to go up to the cowl lights inside the car, because it's the front-facing turn signals. But for right now, I've got these wires here. I need to connect all these, so it's just basically color to color. So let's just start with the outsidemost wire and just start connecting.
Since the turn signals use the same bulb as the brake lights, the only way to test those is with all this hooked up, because it goes through the turn signal actuator. So stomp on the brake and bingo, they work. Huzzah!
Just hooking up the cowl lights now. These will be the front-facing turn signals as well as cowl lights. And because the wires into the sockets of the lights are kind of funky, I didn't want to have to redo that, at least not right now. So I'm not running this all the way in. I'm just going to run this to the existing wire, put one of these butt splice things on there, and call it good. Get this up out of the way. Now the cowl lights are wired. Now all I got to do is change the 12 volt bulbs to 6 volt bulbs. We should have a complete electrical system now.
So I got all the lights working. Everything was fantastic. Even the brake lights, the turn signals, everything was working. So then I grabbed the camera to record the video to show you how it all works. And then it failed. All of a sudden, nothing. So as it turns out, the flasher quit. The brand new electronic 6-volt flasher failed. So I'm going to have to grab a new flasher and install it. But at least everything worked for a minute before the flasher failed. So that's why I don't like electronics. Not much left to do now except the cosmetic stuff. Put the taillight lenses on. Tidy up things in the car, mount the flasher after I get the new flasher that works. And by the way, I love the way Snyder's packages things. If anybody from Snyder's is watching, I'd love for you guys to sponsor me. That'd be great. But speaking of sponsors, I just want to thank Larry Buckwalter, Paul Moore, and Mark Limmer. Thank you so much, guys. You guys sponsored this build, and it wouldn't happen without you guys, so thank you so much for that. So, next video, what's going to happen? Well, this car obviously needs to be completed here and put back together, and then, of course, we need to drive it. So, the next video is going to be the one where you see us put the interior in and get this thing road ready, and maybe even take it on a tour. I don't know. Maybe it'll go on the club tour, or maybe it'll just go to town at least, something. But we got to at least drive it at least once, especially after all this work, right? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.